Hello everyone, welcome to COMP382, Languages, Machine and Computation. In this video, we are going to talk about decision problems for regular languages. So what is a decision problem for a class of languages? A decision problem is a question that you ask about a class of languages. For example, here we are going to focus on regular languages. And the answer for this question is going to be yes or no. So let me give you some example. For example, assume you have two DFAs, you wanted to check if they are equivalent or not, they are accepting the same language or not. This is a decision problem, right? This is a decision problem about the regular languages. And the answer for that is yes or no. Or for example, given two DFAs, we wanted to check if the language that is represented by these two DFAs have any string in common or not. The intersection of the languages are empty or not. Or for example, given any DFA, we wanted to check if it accepts a specific a string or not. You can see that these are all questions about a specific class of languages, and the answer for them is yes or no. So in decision problems, and when you're actually checking the decision problems for a set of languages, the thing that we are interested in is, can we actually solve the decision problem or not? It means that, can we find an algorithm to solve that decision problem or not? For example, can we find an algorithm that you pass it any two DFAs and check if they are equivalent or not? So we are interested to find out that algorithm. Is it possible to find an algorithm or not? And in all of these cases, the algorithm that we are looking for, the input for that is the a DFA, or for example, more than one DFA, and the answer for the algorithm should be yes or no. So the very first and simplest problem, decision problem, is membership problem or question. Given any language or DFA and a string, we wanted to check if the string belongs to that language. How can we solve this for if we are talking about the regular languages? So if the language is regular, we can create a DFA for that. So you just need to create the DFA, pass the string through that DFA, and check if it actually ends up to a final state or not. If it ends up to a final state, yes, the string belongs to the language. Otherwise, the string doesn't belong to the language. Very simple. This is membership question. Another decision problem is equality test. Given to finite state, we wanted to check if they are equivalent or not, they are accepting the same language or not. How can we solve this question? The thing is, the problem is not does not really look simple to do to solve. You know that languages can have, I mean, the DFAs that you are checking, they might actually represent the same language and have completely different state diagrams. So comparing the state diagrams is not going to be something simple, especially because the number of states might be different, the diagram completely might be different, but they are accepting the same language. So someone might actually say that, okay, just minimize the number of states. We know the algorithm for minimizing the number of finite states, right? The number of states in a finite state. We have talked about that. So you can apply, you can minimize the finite state in both of, you can minimize the number of states in both of finite states and then compare the transition diagrams. So comparing the transition diagrams, is going to be a difficult problem. Although the good thing here is that, okay, so if you have two DFAs, you can minimize the number of states in each one and then compare the state diagrams. The problem is going to be converted to comparing two graphs, for example, these two graphs these two transition diagrams basically are the same. But for us, it's not going to be easy to compare because you have to write down an algorithm to do that. But anyway, it is doable. Something good about this is that it is doable. You can compare two graphs and check if they are isomorphic, if they are representing the same transition diagram or not. But I'm going to actually show you that it is possible to find a simpler approach to solve the same problem. But the first thing to know that, okay, this decision problem is solvable for finite state machines, for the regular languages. If you have two finite state machines, you can check if they are representing the same language or not. But that simpler approach that I'm going to show you is that we know we have already talked about the properties of regular languages and how to create A minus M. Remember, A minus M can be actually represented as A intersection M complete, right? So it is possible how to create the complement of a DFA, and then you know how to create the intersection of two DFAs. So you can simply find the A minus M, and if you create A minus M, you just need to check that if A minus M is empty or not. Although you have to actually just compare M minus A as well. If both of these two are empty, they are going to actually represent the same language. Now the question is going to be, how can I check if a DFA is empty or not? Okay, so this decision problem is called emptiness test. We have a language, we wanted to see if the language is empty or not. We have a DFA, we wanted to see if it represents an empty language or not. One algorithm to do here is to run the reachability test. What is a reachability test? A reachability test is that you start from the starting state in your DFA, in your finite state, and you try to find a path from the starting state to any accepting state. If there is a path, then your DFA is going to accept at least one string. And if you cannot find any path from the starting state to a final state, then your reachability test has been failed, and there is no string that can be accepted by this DFA. So this is the way that we can actually solve the emptiness test. And how to run the how to implement the reachability test? So your DFA is going to be a graph, right? You can just depth first search or breadth first search. It doesn't matter which one. You can run either of these algorithms over your graph, starting from the start state, and see that if you can reach to any final states, any accepting state. And time complexity for running the depth first search or breadth first search, both of them is going to be O of E. Basically, the correct is going to be O of E plus V. But anyway, this is going to actually just show it the same. So it's going to be a simple test to do. Another approach is that you wanted to check if DFA, if your language is empty or not. Just minimize the number of states, and if you reach to a transition diagram like this, that you have only the starting state and there is no accepting states, then your DFA is going to accept nothing, so the language is going to be empty. I'm just trying to tell you that yes, there are plenty of different approaches, and all of these approaches are going to be polynomial. This approach that I just explained here is going to be polynomial. It's better than that checking the two transition diagram and see that if they are isomorphic or not. Another test that another decision problem that we can ask over the regular languages is, you have a language, you wanted to see if it is finite or infinite. So how to solve this decision problem? You can basically check the DFA for the language, and if you can find any loop in your DFA which is accessible from the starting state, and it actually reach to any accepting state, then your language is going to be infinite. This is one way, and you know that the cost of finding a cycle in a graph again is going to be the cost of doing a depth first search. I'm not going to actually give you the algorithm, but it is possible. You can just search for the algorithm. The next decision problem that we are going to check is, given a language, we wanted to see if the language is equal to the set of all possible strings over the alphabet or not, that we actually show it as sigma star. So can we solve this decision problem for the regular languages? Yes, we can basically create a DFA for the, you can actually find the, create a DFA for the language and then create a DFA for the complement of the language. We know the algorithm for that, right? And then just check that the complement of the language is equal to empty or not. If it is equal to empty, we already actually know how to check to compare a DFA and check if it accepts empty set or not. We just explained that. If we can do that, if the answer is yes, so the language is equal to the set of all possible strings over the alphabet. Otherwise, it's not going to be. The answer for the question is no. The next, the last decision problem that we are going to discuss for regular languages is, you have two languages. We wanted to see if one of them is the subset of the other one. For example, you have two languages A and B. We wanted to check if A is a subset of B or not. All the S strings in A should be in B. Okay, so how to solve this? We can simply just find the A minus B. Again, this can be done using the intersection of A and the complement of B. We know the algorithm for finding the complement. We know the algorithm to finding the intersection of two DFAs. And we know how to check if it is equal to empty or not. If it is equal to empty, it means that all the strings in A are available in B, so A is going to be a subset of B. So we have talked about several decision problems about regular languages. The first, an important fact about decision problems is that we only are interested, when we are talking about decision problem for a set of languages, for a class of languages, we are only interested to know if it is solvable or not. If the cost of the algorithm is not that important, although definitely we always wanted to find the best approach, the fastest approach, but the main question is that, is it solvable or not? And then after that, can we find a polynomial answer for that or not? So as we see, almost all of the decision problems that we can ask about regular languages are going to be solvable, and we basically can find a polynomial algorithm to solve them. But it is interesting to know that for other classes of languages in the Chomsky hierarchy, we will later on see that many of these decision problems are not solvable. We cannot check two, for example, context-free languages and see if they are equivalent or not. There is no algorithm to check that. Although for the context-free languages, they are going to be still a simple language in the hierarchy, and we can solve some of the decision problems, but most of these decision problems that we talked about here about the regular languages are not solvable even for the context-free languages. For the higher, the languages in the higher levels, this is going to be definitely more difficult. And this is going to cover section 3 of chapter 4. So please read the textbook and solve the exercises.